Ever wanted your own personal streaming setup? With BeeStation Plus, you can store and stream your favorite movies, shows, or family videos anytime, anywhere, no tech headaches required. It's designed for media lovers who want a simple way to take control of their content. And with Plex Media Server built in, turning your BeeStation Plus into a home theater is just a few easy steps away. In today's video, we'll show you how to install Plex Media Server on BeeStation Plus, complete the initial setup, manage your media files, and set up remote access so your content plays seamlessly wherever you are. You can find the timestamps for each section in the video description. Before we get started, if you don't have a Plex account yet, let's create one first. We'll need to link your Plex account later when we install Plex. Go to the BeeStation portal and sign in. Click System Settings, then find Integration, and install Plex Media Server from there. We'd recommend going with Install Using Plex Claim Token. It's a quicker and easier way to get set up if you already have a Plex account. Just click Get Plex Claim Token, sign into your Plex account, and paste that token into the setup wizard. That's it, your BeeStation will automatically link to your Plex account. Of course, if you prefer, you can also choose Install Normally. That option installs Plex without linking to an account right away. You can always connect it later through the Plex web app. Don't close this page just yet. We still have a bit more to set up in the next step. Next, we'll walk you through how to complete the initial setup. Before we jump in, just make sure your computer is on the same local network as your BeeStation Plus, since the initial setup needs to be done locally. Go to the Integration tab, click Open, and then select Open with Local Network to begin the initial setup. Then click Sign into your Plex account. Once you're signed in, you'll see the Plex interface. If you chose Install Normally earlier, you might be asked to name your server and manage your media libraries. For instructions on how to do this, please check out the article in the link. Click More in the left sidebar on Plex, and you should see BeeStation Plus listed there. And that's it, you've finished the setup. You can open Plex anytime by clicking the Plex icon in the upper right navigation menu in BeeStation Plus. Now let's move on to the next part, managing your media files. Next, we're going to upload some videos to your BeeStation Plus. To do that, just go to System Settings, click Integration, and then choose Upload Media Files in BeeFiles. This will open the Plex Media Library folder in BeeFiles. BeeStation Plus comes with 5 ready-to-use folders: movies, music, other videos, photos, and TV shows. Each folder can later be linked to a library in the Plex. You can also create your own folders like anime, or subfolders under an existing folder, such as a sci-fi category under the movies folder. Just make sure they're located inside the Plex Media Library. Plex can only access files within it. Here's a quick tip. Try to upload your content like movies, shows, and more into the right folders. Don't just dump everything into one place. Plex works way better when different types of content are kept nice and separate. If you've previously backed up video files to BeeStation, you can easily move them to the Plex Media Library. Just right-click the file and select Move to move them to Plex Media Library. One of the most popular features in Plex is how it automatically adds movie posters, cast info, summaries, and more, just like Netflix. To make that magic happen, Plex relies on file names to match your videos with its database. For best results, each type of video has a different naming format. You can find more details in the linked article. Once your media is uploaded, we'll go into Plex to set up media libraries. These match the folders you just uploaded on BeeStation and help display your content in Plex. First, open Plex. On the left sidebar, click More, Then hover over your BeeStation Plus and click the plus icon to add a new library. Next, choose the library type like movies or TV shows, give it a name, and pick a language. Plex uses the type you select to better understand what kind of content it's dealing with, so be sure to pick the one that matches your media. Click Browse for Media Folder, scroll to Plex Media Library, and select the folder you want to link. The folder Plex Media Library and Plex Media Server look really similar. Make sure to select Plex Media Library, because Plex Media Server is a system folder used for internal application data, like settings and logs. Once you're done, just click Add, then Add Library to finish up. Your uploaded media should start showing up shortly. If it doesn't, no worries. Just hover over the library, click the three-dot menu, and select Scan Library Files to give it a little nudge. Nice, you're all set to start streaming your media with Plex right from your BeeStation Plus. Next, let's take a look at advanced setting that can improve your viewing experience, especially if you're watching away from home. Want to stream videos away from home? Plex offers a relay service, but for a smoother experience, you can set up direct remote access. Note that you'll need a Plex Pass for this. Now click More in the left sidebar. Then hover over your BeeStation Plus, click the three-dot menu, go to Manage Server, then Settings, and select Remote Access. Here, make sure Remote Access is enabled. If you see not available outside your network, try clicking Enable Remote Access. If the issue persists, it may be related to your router's Universal Plug and Play, UPnP settings. The first option is to enable the UPnP setting on your router. Plex will then automatically configure a forwarded port without requiring any manual setup. While the setup on each router is different, the follow example is based on Synology router. To adjust your router settings, sign in to Synology Router Manager. That's the management interface for your Synology router. Next, go to Network Center. Click Local Network. Find the network your BeeStation Plus is connected to. By default, this is usually the primary network. And click Edit. Under the Advanced tab, make sure UPnP is enabled. If your router doesn't support UPnP, or if you prefer to manually forward a port for Plex, you can set up port forwarding manually. Go to Network Center, click on Port Forwarding, and hit Create. Here, give your rule a custom name, something like Plex on BeeStation Plus. Next, select your BeeStation Plus as the device. For both the private and public port, enter 32400. If you want to use a different public port, that's fine too. Just remember to note it down because you'll need to enter it later. Click Create, then Apply. Return to the Plex interface. Go to Settings, then Remote Access. If you enable UPnP, click Retry directly. If you set up port forwarding manually, check Manually Specify Public Port. Enter the port number and click Retry. If you entered a port number other than 32400 earlier, enter it here. If successful, you'll see fully accessible outside your network. In more complex network setups, additional troubleshooting may be needed. See Plex's Remote Access Help article. And that's it. With BeeStation Plus, you and your family now have your very own personal streaming setup. Sit back, relax, and enjoy great entertainment anywhere. To get the most out of your BeeStation, subscribe to the Synology YouTube channel and click the videos here to keep exploring more Synology features.